Now, you may have seen a lot of these reviews for Black Ops 3, but I can assure you this one's different. No, I can't. I just wanted to do a review because it's kind of coming back to play Call of Duty, and a good Call of Duty is kind of, well, it's been a bit weird for me because I used to play Call of Duty a lot, but then I just totally stopped. And now I've got a new one. I borrowed Black Ops 3 off my friend, so that's how I've acquired it. But I love it actually, and I didn't think I would, but because I did borrow it earlier on. In fact, I suppose I did play it on PC once and liked it, but I don't know. I just really like it for some reason. And it's kind of having this game has made me play console for like has made me really concentrate on console and play that for ages and not play for ages on PC in like a long time. I should probably try and simplify that sentence. It's kind of so having this game has kind of made me, I don't know, play console a lot more. And I was going to say my console aiming skills just got a lot better, but from that clip it's not so evident. But yeah, actually my aiming skill has got a lot better. And yeah, it just feels so good to play another Call of Duty game. I don't know, it feels like I've been invited back to, I don't know, a family. I've never been invited back to a family. I've always stayed in the same one. But I don't know, the Call of Duty family. I mean, the Battlefield family is a totally different thing. But that's just a way of describing it. Yeah, that's just kind of how I feel. But anyway, getting into the game, what do I like about it? Well, in fact, going through campaign, multiplayer, and zombies. In fact, I might go campaign, then zombies, then multiplayer. So, for the campaign anyway, it seems good. Gameplay seems good. It's pretty much entirely scripted, like any other Call of Duty campaign. There's always a good and evil, so it's got good and evil in it. Kind of not so original in that aspect. It's kind of carried on from the Black Ops 2 customization system in the campaign, where you can choose what guns you have and kind of abilities you have, which is a really nice touch. I really do like that. I haven't really played much of the campaign, but I can't, to be honest, I can't be asked. And I will explain why. Now, I think it's good, but the whole kind of thruster system, I'd like to be able to use those individual thrusters more in the actual campaign, because that was the problem with Advanced Warfare as well. You actually hardly used your exosuit even though you had it. Which kind of, well, what's the point of having it in the game but not using it that much for the campaign? It's a bit inconsistent as well. The gore's kind of even worse this time than I mean, that's not a bad thing, but because they've also introduced dismemberment into the campaign, but in not the campaign multiplayer, but in the campaign, it's kind of, I suppose that's from World at War, to be honest. But anyway, in the campaign, like there's people's like there's a bit where you go into a room and then people have no noses. Have no nose, and it's been totally chopped off. So I feel like gore has ramped up from the worst thing in Black Ops 1 being like someone being hit on the back of the head with a pipe and then a lot of blood coming out, to Black Ops 2, someone's knee bones being shown after they've been absolutely thwacked by like a big wrench. And now to total dismemberment and like harm of, I don't know, bodily parts. So I don't know if it's going to keep on getting worse and worse and worse, but it's not a bad thing. I'm not too bothered by it, but I'm just saying. So yeah, there were some interesting things. The story, I haven't really picked up on it that much because I haven't really played that much of it, and it's kind of, I don't know, the whole world's going to kind of is nearly in an apocalypse, just like Black Ops 2. Oh, and Black Ops, like any other Call of Duty game, I suppose. But the actual story doesn't seem to relate to the other Black Ops games that much. I mean, Black Ops 2 didn't seem to relate to Black Ops 1 that much. I mean, I suppose it did have Mason in it, but the actual story, it was kind of a new story, not related to like the Nova, what's it called? Nova 6? Nova 6 gas, that the communists were gonna put out everywhere to America and stuff, like in Black Ops 1. It came up with a totally new story, and it's done it again, but it doesn't seem to have any relation between characters to the other characters. And it's kind of annoying for me because that kind of tells me that they've just used the Black Ops title just to gain it more popularity. And this game would probably be better suited to another title since it doesn't actually fulfill the other Black Ops games. It kind of ticks me off a bit. I mean, I suppose, yeah, that's what I think about the campaign, to be honest. I think it's good, but it just doesn't relate at all to Black Ops 2 or Black Ops 1. I think it's post Black Ops 2, but I think it should have been done under another title. So anyway, moving on to zombies. I don't know what to say about this one. I only own one zombies map because I haven't bought anything else on top, which is Shadows of Evil. It's complicated, it's boring, and it's just hard, and it's bad overall. I am deeply kind of just annoyed with zombies this time around. Like in Black Ops 2, it was amazing. In Black Ops 1, it was amazing. World at War, that was, well, it was all right. Actually, it was amazing as well. I suppose in World at War, you got one map, but in Black Ops 1, I think you got two maps, and in Black Ops 2, you got, what's it like? I don't know, actually. Oh yeah, you got Transit, which was made up of four little maps. That was one map. I suppose that was also a game mode, but anyway. Then you got four little maps to go with it that were, and they were what made up Transit. And Town was probably my favourite map, one of my favourite maps in Black Ops 2. And that was just like a little map that made up Transit. Because it's so simple, and you don't have to do loads of rubbish just to get pack-a-punch, like in something like Buried. However, they've still done that thing that they did in Buried and everything like that, where you have to go through loads of stuff, do loads of stuff to get pack-a-punch and perks and in Shadows of Evil. It's just annoying to me, and it doesn't actually have, like, it seems to have all these new creatures in it, but zombies is called zombies because of a reason, because it's got zombies in it, not because it's got a bunch of squids running around. And I suppose Isendrak, it's well, the giant. No, not Isendrak. That's a totally different DLC. The giant, which is, I forgot the name of it. That map's just got zombies in it, and it's very simple. I haven't played it, but I know it. So because it's back from World at War, when things were simple, and then Black Ops 1 made it more kind of less simplified, and Black Ops 2 just went over the top, and now Black Ops 3 has totally went over the top. It annoys me, and the thing that annoys me the most is that I have to pay £35 to get five zombies map on top of the one I already own. And they're not even necessarily good, they're just zombie maps. It's completely silly. I have to pay like more than the game is worth right now to actually get more content in the game. And it really does annoy me. I suppose that's what you've had to do for World at War, Black Ops 2, and Black Ops 1. But the thing is, it's not really. I just hope that they gave us another, like, more maps instead of just Shadows of Evil. It's when you buy a game, you expect it to be completely ready and full of content it should have, but yet you have to buy more. And that's just like, it tells you that Call of Duty are really into their money. And just premium, Battlefield Premium, and the season pass for Call of Duty just annoys me, to be honest. I don't know why it's a thing, and it's just because they want more money for their game. Anyway, so moving on to multiplayer, and the multiplayer is absolutely fantastic. It is. I find it so fun. I'm actually speechless. Fun to the point of speechless. It is just one of the best multiplayer in, well, one of the best Call of Duty multiplayers I've played in a long time. And it's a multiplayer that makes me want to keep on coming back to it every day, just to try and get better and keep on unlocking new stuff. It's kind of like Battlefield 4, until I played it for 11 days. I mean, in fact, I still go back to that game, but yeah, it is just really good. I really enjoy it. And oh, pardon me. So the mechanics are like, so there's the, it's got thruster mechanics in it, and oh man, so they've kind of extended on the combined kind of jetpack mechanics of Advanced Warfare and made them into something called thrusters, which lets you kind of have free running abilities where you run on walls and you jump over stuff like that's higher. You can now swim underwater, like there's proper swimming now, as you can see here. And the graphics are just like, on the side, the graphics are just amazing for console. I like, they seriously did this game out really good for console. Like, seriously. I'm utterly amazed. It looks like one of the best games you can play on PS4 right now. Full 1080p, nearly ultra graphics probably. In fact, when I played it on PC, it nearly looked exactly like this on PS4. But anyway, so thrusters are really clever mechanics, and it's better than the jetpacks used in Advanced Warfare, or what, exosuits, sorry, because you have a kind of faint idea of where your enemy can be, and you know they can't just be, like, I don't know, 500 meters up in the sky above you. You know they'll just be like 2 meters up above you, but you know where they can come in, and there's always entry points. In Advanced Warfare, you never really knew where anybody could come from, which was an annoying factor to it. So they really did nail the kind of, I don't know, jetpack thruster slash booster mechanics in Black Ops 3. They really did nail it, and I think one of the reasons why it works as well is because it blends kind of sprinting and walking and stuff with like flying about, because the maps still work. That guy just fell off the edge. Wee plop. So what was I even saying? So the maps still work if you don't have thrusters, and if there was an ability to take thrusters off, which means that you don't like depend on thrusters a lot. In fact, thrusters seems to be a kind of a way of getting to a way of nailing your enemy. It's a tactic, to be honest. It's not really that essential in Black Ops 3, in my opinion. Which is good, because it's kind of, it's Call of Duty, not the kind of hybrid of, I don't know, Titanfall that Advanced Warfare made Call of Duty. So they really did nail the thruster mechanics, and they introduced quite a lot of stuff into this Call of Duty, so you can't just argue that it's the same every year. I suppose you can argue that they're kind of going for the same thing from Advanced Warfare, but and carrying it on into Infinity, Infinite Warfare. Infinite Warfare, not Infinite Warfare. I'm saying it the American way. anyway, so specialist abilities. Well, killstreaks are pretty much the same. But there's something new called specialists, where you choose a specialist and that acts as your character. Now, this is more proof of Call of Duty being more of an arena game, and there's nothing wrong with that. We all like a good arena game, for example, Overwatch. But it really isn't a military game anymore. So if you haven't played Call of Duty since COD 4 and thought that COD 4 was the best military shooter you've ever played, then you might have a different opinion on the newer Call of Duty games, especially Black Ops 3. Because with the specialist thing, it kind of follows in the footsteps of Overwatch, where you choose a character. Now, it doesn't have that much influence on how you play, like picking a different specialist, but you do get to pick a specialist ability, which over time, well, lets you use the specialist ability, and if you get a kill, it also makes the time faster. So, the specialist ability is pretty much a killstreak. It's pretty much a killstreak weapon, or kind of killstreak ability style, killstreak reward style ability that you can earn from not being good. So basically, it's the killstreak system for noobs, and it's a really clever move on Call of Duty's part, or I suppose Treyarch's part, actually. Because there's been a lot of kind of "we don't like killstreaks" from people, but because it just rewards good players, and the bad players who want to get better don't get rewarded for their good work. So this has kind of rewarded them, because every once in a while they'll get a specialist ability, which is a really cool feature. I really like it, and they're not too OP either. I mean, to be honest, there is balancing issues, like major balancing issues on PC with specialist abilities. Like the Annihilator is just the best specialist weapon that you can have. Custom game modes seem to be, well, anyway, guns seem to be a bit more wacky than Black Ops 2. They don't have ballistic knives in, or a crossbow. Well, I suppose actually saying that, they do have a crossbow in, but it's not the same as the other two, which is also a thing that is, I think they should have renamed this game under a new title and not Black Ops. But I don't mind them not having sticks and stones in. They still have tomahawks, but I just wish they kind of kept that over. I mean, I suppose the crossbow was just awful in both games. You never use that thing in actual team deathmatch combat, only in sticks and stones. There's the specialists, and at the end of the match, wonder if anybody's going to do it. Yeah, you can do different animations, like on the right. I don't know, it's more proof of an arena-style game. It's funny, and yeah. Now, however, everything's not so good in the multiplayer. For example, I feel like some of the gunplay is just a bit random for, like, my aim here isn't as good as it could be, because I was still kind of figuring out how to play the game. For example, I nearly kill a guy with my submachine gun, but then he quickly slides behind a car, which you can't, or like a wall which you can't pierce with bullets. I mean, there's very little objects you can actually pierce in Black Ops 3, but it's kind of, I suppose it's a lot, it's changed a lot since COD 4, because you could almost pierce every surface in COD 4. But anyway, so he quickly slides behind a surface you can't pierce, and then my aim assist makes me aim at him behind the surface. I shoot a bullet which should hit the wall, but actually he dies behind a wall. Now, I don't really know if this is a kind of illusional problem, a virtual problem, or an actual kind of factual problem. I would either name it under, I don't know, bad net coding. I mean, it has actually got brilliant net coding in Black Ops 3. Definitely better than Black Ops. I mean, Black Ops 2 netcoding was good, but just the host migrations and the lagginess of everything was just so annoying. So I don't really know what it is, and there's definitely no kind of bullet velocity, so I don't know what's up with that. I think it might. I really don't know. And also, the kill cam is as bad as it was in Black Ops 2, where you might kill somebody with a quickscope in like a custom match, and then at the end, when it shows it in the kill cam, it tries to recreate what happened, but the bullet hole actually. Well, the bullet hole and the tracer line go to a wall next to the guy, and it never even hits the guy, and but then he magically dies. So yeah, I mean, they are little problems. I think if you're playing competitive, the first one I mentioned, where you can kill people behind cover sometimes just randomly, that would be bigger to you. And I know I have got some friends who play competitively, so that, I don't know if they've ever encountered that. But that is a problem that I think it could do with fixing for competitive people, because it can be annoying, and it could be as annoying as Battlefield 4 10 Hz netcoding, 10 Hz stick rate, where you run behind a wall and then you get shot by some guy who's actually behind the wall, like on either side. So yeah, and also one of the problems that really annoys me, and it's kind of come over from Black Ops 2 as well. Just problems where you can't join a private match, can't join your friend in a private match for some reason, and you actually have to restart your game to get it working. And this always used to happen in Black Ops 2, and the amount of times it happens in Black Ops 3 is just, I don't know why when they built a new engine this problem has still come over. But yeah, it is annoying and it needs fixing. And although I suppose if I compare this to Black Ops 2, the multiplayer, I would say I find it more enjoyable than Black Ops 2, because map design in Black Ops 2 was quite, well, it was horrendous. And but map design is pretty good in this game, I must say. It is in fact really good. I feel like Black Ops 3 is kind of, I don't know, it kind of succeeds on Black Ops 2, not for zombies. But the problem is it's not Black Ops, in my opinion. It doesn't really feel like Black Ops. It doesn't relate to, especially the campaign, it doesn't relate to any of the Black Ops titles. Except for zombies, because that's, well, Black Ops and World at War, they're the only zombies games that have actually, well, they're the only Call of Duty games that have actually had proper zombies, and not, I mean, I suppose Advanced Warfare had zombies, but it was such a rip-off and copycat move by Sledgehammer there. I don't know why they did it. And it just got absolutely, well, it was bad. So anyway, to sum up this game, I think it is a brilliant Call of Duty game. And we've been having a lot of bad Call of Duties so far. And this has kind of brought it back into one of the best games to buy for like consoles. It's new, it's innovative, it succeeds on Advanced Warfare, it succeeds on some of the problems of Black Ops 2. One of the most evident is bad net coding. Well, horrible I mean, it still runs on peer-to-peer networks for servers. It doesn't actually have a server that powers it, which is still annoying. But I have so, like, the amount of connection problems and host migrations and everything like that is a lot less. I mean, that might be to do with PS3, but definitely a lot less. So I think they did a good job with that. Also a brilliant job with graphics. Graphics are amazing. But, and also, to sum it up as well, I've said this many, many a time, but it doesn't relate to Black Ops to me at all. So I think they should have just put it under a new title, and they just simply put it under Black Ops to get it popular, to get it more popular among the fans, and more waited for. And also, zombies, I shouldn't have to spend extra money to get more maps. So that's it, and thanks for watching, and I have really enjoyed doing this review, so I'm really enjoying playing this game as well. So thanks.